Truthfully, the only thing that really matters at the end of the day is understanding people and psychology and placement and what is working and not working.
What do you do when you're getting lots of traffic, but you're not getting any conversion?
Lots of traffic, no conversion. Okay, it may be that you don't actually have lots of traffic, but you think you do. Do you have quality traffic? Is it targeted traffic? Because if not, what you have to do is you have to start to segment your traffic out. And you have to start to say, okay, so I have the 100,000 visitors each day coming, but only 10,000 of those visitors are people I actually want. So through your analytics, through your architecture and the steps within your funnel that you set up, you have to be able to determine or put indicators in to determine how you qualify those people or bucket those people, build those groups and those audiences to determine, okay, out of the 100,000, only 10,000 are right. Let's say of those 10,000 people though, you still expect a higher conversion and they're not converging. So then the next challenge becomes, okay, do we have the right type of people coming? Do we have them coming in high enough numbers? Then it's really a messaging thing. It really comes down to where are they landing? What are they looking for? What are we saying? It could be that your design sucks. It could be that the landing page sucks. It could be that you're not saying the right message. So you have to start to question, are you split testing your messaging? Are you taking the time to make really quantifiable changes? Is it aligning with their needs and desires? If you have a research site like Wikipedia, let's say, and you're trying to sell someone a pair of shoes, you're gonna have a pretty low conversion. That's to be expected. No one is coming to you to buy a pair of shoes. They're coming there to do research. You can't expect them to convert. So then you have to decide, like, if you have this research site and they're coming and you want to sell them something, what are you doing to build up a funnel or to be able to create a difference between them coming in, them doing the research, them coming back, them learning about you, them signing up for an email or downloading something or deciding to come out to an event and then eventually down the line purchase something. But if you have a lot of traffic and you have trouble converting people, then you have to question, is it the right traffic and are we saying the right things? And when they're coming, are they type of traffic that can actually be converted? And as you work deeper and deeper and deeper, you want to start to align and fix these things. And so when you have the right type of traffic and you know they're coming for the right reason and you're giving them the right message, then it comes down to, like, are we the brand? Do we have the tone? Do we have the design? Do we have the style? Is it clear? Is it intuitive? All of these things really come down to UX and being able to really understand user experience. And it starts with who they are. It doesn't start with a question like, how do I get more traffic, or I have lots of traffic, right? You're problem solving all the way down the funnel. And once you crack the code at each step, all it does is kick down to the next level, the new challenge that you have to crack. And then you're gonna get all the way down the bottom and you say, yes, I gotta figure it out. And then, you know, over 10 months, 12 months, 15, 18 months, everything starts to slip back. Because it's never over. It's never set it and forget it. It's something you have to continually figure out as the market dynamics shift, as the traffic sources change, as your competition starts to eat into your traffic that you're getting. You have to constantly fight for awareness. You have to constantly help drive people through the process, and you have to build a funnel that pulls them through so that way ultimately they hit the conversion point you want. And then you got to right size it so it all makes sense for you.
How do you manage multi-platform advertising and decide where your money needs to go?
So there's two different questions there. So let's start first, not with the management. Let's actually start with where your money needs to go. It's a great question. So do you know your target audience? Do you know who they are, what they want, and then do you know where they are? Because if you know who they are and what they want and where they are, then that starts to help shape where you should be advertising. Does it make sense for you to advertise in a place where none of your customers are at? Not at all. And the next thing to decide is, like, how much to spend, where to spend, and all of these things, is you have to start to be able to test in market whether you can allow that channel to work for you, to right size with your cost of acquisition. You can afford to spend a certain amount of money to make a sale. And anything more than that means you're overspending to make that sale. And anything below that, I mean, of course you want to go below that, that's amazing. But everyone wants to go below that through testing and optimization, but you have to start somewhere. So really you have this ceiling for what you're willing to spend. And so in that channel, if you know your customers are there, what you need to do is get in front of them with a small test campaign, and you need to see what the cost of acquisition is. What does it cost to get someone to do the conversion that you want them to do? And then you establish a baseline. And through testing and optimizing, you should arrive at a place where you have a pretty predictable outcome. I put this much money in, I get these results back. If you know that your targets are on two or three or four different platforms or places, you can now start to compare things. And you can say, well, what is my cost of acquisition on this channel versus this channel or platform or whatever it is? And you can start to look at, what does it cost for me to acquire a client? So if you have a fixed budget, you have to decide, okay, so I have these three channels, each of them I've right-sized, I've tested, I've optimized, I have a cost of acquisition. I only have so much budget I'm spending and I'm not overspending my campaign. So I'm gonna take all of my dollars and put it here where it's cheapest. And then I'm gonna put my spillover, because I can't overspend that one, into the next one and the next one. Or you might be looking to take a more protective approach, right? My competitors are in all of these platforms, and even though my cost of acquisition is right-sized in each of these platforms, I don't wanna be absent in a platform, I still wanna be visible, so my competition doesn't get it, so I'm gonna mix my spend across. Now, can I raise my spend? Can I go from the $1,000 to the $10,000 per month, or the $10,000 to the $40,000 per month? Can I raise my spend while holding that cost of acquisition? Can I move out to new markets while holding that cost of acquisition? And I mean, listen, none of this stuff is set it and forget it. Everything is about trying and pursuing an answer, seeing what results come in, making an assessment, and making changes. That is what marketing is.
Can you build a business out of just tracking marketing progress and analyzing it?
100%. So I'm assuming what the person's asking is whether they can build a business as someone who does analytics and reporting and insight and basically just market tracking for the customer. And I think 100% you can, but it depends on the type of client that you're working with. And so are you gonna crush that part of the industry? Because I mean, of course, creative matters and production matters and the way you message everything and brand building and strategy and all those things matter, but they're all becoming more increasingly commoditized and driven through AI and different platforms. Truthfully, the only thing that really matters at the end of the day is understanding people and psychology and placement and what is working and not working. And so you can leverage AI and different analytics tools to tell you what is happening, but people really struggle with what they should do next. Doctor runs a blood test to tell you what's happening, but what should you do with that data? That is where the real value is. That is what people are willing to pay a lot for, but more than anything, if you're really amazing at it, builds an incredible amount of value and trust. And so if you are looking to basically use user data or marketing tactics or activities to be able to build clean pieces of insight that can inform what to do next or how to do it or how to tweak or how to get better, that is massively important. That is huge. Can you build a business around it? 100%. Like call me up and tell me who you are, because I want to hire you.
How much of a factor does this play in your business?
It's huge. I honestly think that strategy and executing on strategy is everything. Being able to build an effective strategy and get buy-in on that strategy is a skill set and is something that's really hard to do. But then executing on that strategy is everything. How do you know if you executed on the strategy? How do you know if the strategy is being performed as effectively as possible? If you're not measuring, if you're not testing, if you're not optimizing, how do you know? That takes an ongoing relationship. It takes the ability to set up channels and tests in ways so that way you put something in market, you are learning, you are measuring, you are then taking that data and understanding what's happening, you're working with a client to then move on to the next steps and you're making iterative improvements. And so if you are not tracking something in your business, then there's no way to make it better. If you don't have actionable insight, or you're not able to take the data that you're getting and actually do something with it, then it's not making you better. And so in marketing, this is core. Unless if you're just gonna be a creative person who produces creative stuff and hands it over, if you're actually responsible for ensuring that clients continue to buy into what you're doing, you need to sell that time and time again. You need to continue to drive value. You need to drive immediate and never-ending value. And that comes from being transparent and reporting back what is working and what's not working and the value that people are getting for money. That's everything. If you want to take your business to the next level by getting stronger at sales, at marketing, at branding, at speaking to people, at understanding your message, your purpose, and everything you need to do to crush it, well, then be sure to subscribe to my channel. I release videos every day. Click on the bell icon so that way you can get the videos when they drop. Or you can check out this video right over here. It will change your life.